So we're moving on to talk about roots and radicals now. And to start this discussion, I need to remind you that 3 squared is 9. This power of 2 here is a square, and that just means you're taking the number 3 and multiplying by itself, which is why you get 9. We can turn this equation around as well and use this funny symbol to say that the square root of 9 equals 3. Now these two equations that I have written down are the exact same equation. This little symbol here is called a radical. We'll also call this a root, and in this specific case, a square. Root. And though we don't use this language very often, the thing under the root is called the radicand. Okay, so what is the square root of 25? The question we're asking here is, what is the number that you would square to get 25? If you think about it for a minute, that number is 5. And as a bit of a side note, if I had asked you what the square root of 26 is, you wouldn't really know without a calculator. The answer is approximately 5.0990195, and this actually goes on forever. So you wouldn't be able to do this without a calculator. Okay, back to the main discussion of roots and radicals. We are allowed to put a negative sign outside of a radical. We can ask the question, what is the square root of 16? The answer is 4, and the negative just stays there. However, what if I wanted to put a negative under a square root? Well, we're asking what number squared would give us negative 16. Well, and as it turns out, there is no number that you can square to get a negative number. There's no number that I could plug into this equation right here to give me negative 16 on the right-hand side. So what we do is we say that this is not a real number. And as we're going to learn later in this class, we say it's not a real number because, as it turns out, there are these things called imaginary numbers. And we'll just have to talk about that a bit later. For now, if you get a negative under a square root, it's just not a real number. Okay, let's expand on this a little bit. And remember that 2 squared is going to be 2 times 2, which is 4. 2 cubed is going to be 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. 2 to the 4th power is going to be 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is 16. We can play the same game with negative numbers as well. Negative 3 squared. It's negative 3 times negative 3, which is 9. Negative 3 cubed is negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3. There are 3 negatives in there, so your final answer actually turns out to be a negative 27. And if you have negative 3 to the 4th power, basically all you're doing is multiplying this negative 27 by another negative 3. That's going to turn out to be a positive 81. I had to do the work on the side for that one. Our ability to raise numbers to whatever power we want means that we have as many types of roots as we want as well. So I could rewrite these 3 equations. The first equation says that the square root of 4 is 2. The second equation introduces an idea of a cube root. When we ask for the cube root of 8, we're asking what number cubed would give us 8, and that is 2. We can also say the fourth root of 16 equals 2. And we'll talk more about this in class, but as it turns out, this equation right here also allows us to write out what the cube root of negative 27 is. And the cube root of negative 27 is negative 3. We call this an odd root because the number on the radical is an odd number. And as it turns out, we can take odd roots of negative numbers. Okay, that's the briefest introduction possible. Let's do a couple of examples and see how these can get more complicated. If you want to try these on your own, feel free to hit pause in your browser, but I'm going to start running through them. When you ask what the square root of 100 is, you're asking the question, what number squared is 100? The answer is 10. If you're asking what the cube root of 1,000 is, you're asking what number cubed is 1,000? And again, the answer is 10. If we want the fifth root of 32, you're asking the question, what number raised to the fifth power is 32? If you count it out, the answer is 2. So the fifth root of 32 is 2. Then things are going to get a little bit trickier. We're asking what the square root of x to the sixth is. So you're asking what number squared is going to give you x to the sixth. Well, if you remember your properties of exponents, you'll realize that the answer is x cubed, because x cubed squared is x to the sixth. So the square root of x to the sixth is x cubed. We could combine a couple of these questions together to ask the question, what is the square root of 100x to the sixth? And since these two terms are multiplied in here, we can take these two square roots separately. What's the square root of 100? Well, it's 10. We found that earlier. What is the square root of x to the sixth? It's x cubed. So the square root of 100x to the sixth is 10x cubed. All right, we're going to do a lot more of these in class. I'll see you there.